Hey, what's up everyone? It's Bobby. Today I have a real quick video for you guys. I'm going to be giving you guys my review of two very small, cheap iPhone accessories that are very helpful and useful that I both picked up. Both of these I picked up at Macworld, and I just thought I'd shoot a little combined video of both these because they're both really small and probably not worth the whole video itself. So the first thing I'm going to show you guys is called the Pogo Stylus, which is a capacitive touchscreen stylus. So for those of you that don't know, there's basically two main types of touchscreen devices. There's capacitive touchscreens and resistive touchscreens. And capacitive touchscreens, they respond to a transfer of electrons, I believe, between your finger and the screen, and that's how it registers touch. Whereas resistive touchscreens respond from two different films that when pressed together, they send a signal or whatever. So that's why there's certain touchscreens that you have to push really hard and you can use a stylus to push down on. Those are resistive touchscreens, whereas capacitive touchscreens, you don't have to push hard at all. You just simply like can touch it and it'll recognize the response very easily. But if you touch it with your nail, it doesn't do anything. And if you touch it with the hard part of a stylus, it doesn't do anything. So I'm going to be showing you guys a capacitive stylus that works with all capacitive touchscreen phones. Now, what this is it has little tiny, I believe, capacitors. Don't quote me on that, but it has little felt kind of like material on the tip that registers capacitive touch. And so what you can do is you can simply just take it and use it as if it was a normal stylus. Very smooth, very fluid. It feels just like your finger. You do have to press down a little bit just to register the touch, but it's not hard. It's not like you're straining your arm or anything like that. But it is a capacitive touch stylus. And you can use this for drawing applications, anything along the lines of that. If there's a text input recognition app, who knows? I mean, with the introduction of the iPad coming out really soon, I mean, I'm sure we're going to see some really nice drawing applications and handwriting applications and note-taking. This would be perfect for that. Very, very cheap. I believe it's like under $10. And the company that makes this also has an accessory. What you can do is it's a little clip that goes around one side of your iPhone, and it has a little spot so you can just clip your little stylus in right there. It is a little bulky, and it doesn't really fit with a case. That's why I didn't get one at Macworld, because it just wouldn't fit with any of my cases, and I just figured it was a hassle. But if you like to use the iPhone naked, you don't care, you want to have a little place to keep your stylus so you don't lose it, they also have that option for you too. So it's very, very helpful for those of you who don't like having to use your big fingers to type or anything along the lines of that. Very nice stylus right here. Very good solution to a common problem. Now, the next product I want to show you guys is called the Budsock. Now, basically what this is a cable management system for your headphones and whatnot. And basically the point of this is to keep the earbuds of your headphones safe from getting damaged and to keep it your cables from being untangled. Now, I've been using this fairly frequently, and to be honest with you, I don't really know how helpful this is. I mean, sometimes it's more of a pain using this than it is using just having your headphones in your pocket. But I will show you guys how it works and I will show you how to use it. But just be wary, it is a little difficult to use. Alright, so basically how these work, I'm going to be showing you guys how these work with the Radius Atomic Bass headphones. So basically the point of this is what you have to do is you take your 3.5mm headset, whatever, input or whatever, and you slide it through the Budsock. And then you pull your cable all the way through. The advertiser, you can just let gravity do the work, you just go like that, and it will encase your headbuds inside this little sock right here, if you see that. And then what you're supposed to do is take the end that you slid through and put it right in between these two little metal clips. If you guys see that, these two clips right there. So you put it in between there, you put it until you shove it in until it's just the cable, and then you snap it together. I didn't put it in far enough. Yeah, I did. Okay, so there you guys have it. Your headbud and your ending to your headphones or whatever, those are completely protected. And now basically what they advertise you can do with this is you can just take it, crinkle it up in your hand, any which way, just mess around with it, put it in your pocket, anything like that, total mess. But when you're ready to use it, you just stick your hand in, slide it through, and your cables are not tangled at all. But to be honest with you, it is kind of a pain when you want to start using it, because every time you want to start using your headphones, you have to pop this open, take this out, which is very simple, but then you have to try to get your headphones out, which is kind of a pain. I mean, maybe there's an easier way to do it that I'm just not doing, but there you guys have it. And then what you have to do is you have to like let it go all the way off if you don't want to just leave it on the cable, and then you have your headphones. I mean, it is helpful and it does solve the problem and it does protect your headbuds, but it is a little bit inconvenient for my use of headphones. But for what it's meant to do, I guess it does do it well. So it's a pretty good product. I'm not sure how much it costs. I think it costs maybe $5 or $10 from budsocks.com. I'll put all the links in the description to get these two products, your capacitive stylus from Pogo, the Pogo stylus, and then the Bud Sock. But both of these are pretty good products. I do use these quite often, both of them. I approve of both of these. Go check them out. Very cheap, inexpensive iPhone accessories that will make your life easier. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure you comment below. Let me know if you've used better solutions for either of these problems that these two accessories solve, or if you've used them and you like them, or if you'd like to see something different. Comment below. I really want to know what you guys have to say. Other than that, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you like this video, not rate it 5 stars anymore, because now it's liking. So like this video, and yeah, I will see you guys next time. Peace.